Hi, I'm Janet Steele, Area Forestry and Wildlife Agent with Clemson Extension. Before you begin treating invasive species on your property, one of the most important things to be aware of is the rules and regulations that you must follow when you are using different herbicides and pesticides. One of the best resources for the treatment of invasive species is this publication, A Management Guide to Invasive Plants in the Southern Forest. This publication in hardcover now is very hard to come by, but the entire publication is available online. Guidelines in here are very specific for different invasive species, the time of year they should be treated, and the methods to be used. Most herbicides available for forestry applications are labeled as general use, meaning you do not have to have any kind of pesticide applicator license to purchase and apply these chemicals on your property. Following the guidelines laid out in this publication or any other recommendations should be adhered to strictly. Some chemicals will require a surfactant to be mixed with the chemical before application to help them adhere to the plant or surface they're being applied to. Make sure that you follow closely the recommended number of ounces so that the application, when it's made, will be made effectively and will not be wasting expensive chemicals. Most forestry herbicides can be used for different application methods. This is dependent on the time of the year, the applications to be made, the type of vegetation, and the size of the vegetation. Always remember that the label is the law and do not apply more than the labeled rate. This can cause damage to non-target vegetation and is also very wasteful of chemicals that can be very expensive to purchase and apply.